Hello, it's me, Kisma, and I am welcoming you to this process that I'm undergoing, my virtual digital 3D reality, the 6-month grant that I've been awarded by Second Life Endowment of the Arts, and I am recreating, embellishing, changing, transforming the temple of the divine feminine, once known as the temple of the goddess that I created for America Art, which was a biennale program that ran through 2021, 22, and ended back in May. And so I just got the grant awarded to me July 1st, and I have it through December 31st of 2022, this year. So I've begun to build, and I thought I'll bring you on in so that you can take a look at it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to share my desktop. We're going to be working in two virtual realities. I'm going to walk you around so that you can actually see a little bit of what I have going on. It's a fascinating process. I bring in all my art, so it's based on, my real art, but I'm also building in a virtual 3D environment. Okay, let me share my desktop with you. Hello, this is me, my little avatar in a world called Second Life. And this is the land that I've been awarded. And you can see it's pretty big. I'm gonna zoom out. You can really see it. It's this square, which on the computer doesn't look like much, but it is. And I have the land submerged because I'm creating a bit of a medicine wheel. And where I'm bringing you in at, I'm bringing you right dab into the middle of the sim. And this is the temple of the divine feminine. So I am bringing you into a bit of a yoni, right in through the vulva. So this is where you land. Eventually, you'll rise up this ribbon to a platform above where there will be concerts and other things like that happening, but right here's our pearl of wisdom. Okay, so I have a team of creatives working with me. Secondhand Tootie right there builds 3D mesh objects that are very childlike and in many ways like Nikki Day St. Paul, although this is in no means a Nikki Day St. Paul. But you can see this goddess rising up out of the water right here. Okay, so I'm going to have everybody come down this little pathway into the east. And so right there, as you see, I've got the Eastern goddess. And this is where I'm working right now. I've got a direction for all of them, but this is the cardinal point. And when you come in, you're coming into this environment, and I will have a video playing right here to welcome everyone. And right now it's just set up, but I have a little bit of an invocation. It is to the east I begin and go. Calling forth, maiden goddess, my friend. Come forth, gentle breath of life. Come forth, light of illumination, far-sighted wisdom. Wait, far-sighted eagle eyes, seer of all things new. Clear the cobwebs from my mind and let me be inspired again. I could have put a new, but then I'd be using new twice. All right, whatever. Okay, let's walk the path. This is just an outline. I haven't even begun to fill in this area, and I've got just primary base textures down, but you're going to come through goddess towers, goddess columns into here. And it's the same invocation with the breath and the goddess, the spring, a guardian more or less. And then we come back out. And come through this gateway. This is going into the temple now, the temple of the maiden, the temple of the spring goddess. Okay, one second. Okay, so I'm having some difficulty with a couple of mesh items. These are the things that builders go through. You're not really seeing them from a distance or from when you walk in, these little flowers that I have created here that are spinning with their star. And you see they pop away, they disappear from sight. So it's very disconcerting. Let's see if I go like this, if that will change things. No, it does not. So I'm not quite sure how to have to work on fixing that. Anyways, we come in and I'm showing you that the main altar and the light right now. Hold on a second. Let me go into my world environment. Yes. We're using the share. I'm going to put it at a lesser light. But this is kind of like, you know, the altar of an artist is her workspace where she creates. You know, the altar cloth is the drop cloth. And here are the magic wands and the tools. And I've got a glass of water there for nourishment. And then, of course, the blank untouched canvases, and then the canvases that are, oh, look at that, see, wow. That is oil, seashells. Lots of things have to be fixed. Anyways, I'm just going to walk you through for a moment, but you're going to go in a circle into each of the sections, the different temples, and the different altar spaces. Interactive elements, this shows you the evolution of a painting. And it takes you to the painting, which is right here, Soul Fire. And this is an altar to this divine feminine, and it's the moon blood altar. And there I have tampons as offerings in there. And I might have a few other things. All right. This alcove comes into metacognitive creativity. Spring goddess is the goddess of the mind, and metacognitive is about thinking, you know, being focused. And so I've got the different creations for that, with the diamond of clarity and keeping you nice and focused with the flame, the candle flames. I just finished those. Diamonds of thought. Into the next quadrant that I'm just beginning to work on. So you can see a little bit of what I, of how I work, but one of the things I'm going to be doing is I Res2Prim. These are the build tools. And I'm going to make this into Oh God, things just really go wonky in here. I've done is I'm creating an alter face to go right here. Oops. Okay, so just do. Okay, so now I'm going to bring in a digitally enhanced version of that. Wait. Hold on a second. You can see I got a problem there. Okay. So that's a cubed version of the painting that's behind it, just to give it. Let's see if all right. So for now, that's all I'm going to show you. And until next time, let me get around to my Lavatar face. And until I see you again, have fun. All right. So, anyways, working with prims and in a virtual environment can sometimes be a challenge, but it's really kind of fun. I really, really enjoy it. And what I love is the end result where I can walk around it in an avatar or film it and see what it would be life size, because I have my avatar height the same height as my human height. And so everything I build is based on that dimension, that measurement. So it's kind of fun. It'd be really cool to be able to create. It's magic. It's magic. All right. That's all I'm going to say for now. Thanks for joining me.